Before mounting the pistons with piston rings in the cylinders, we recommend inspecting and measuring all parts. Measuring these parts is not only necessary with used parts, you should always measure and check new parts as well, and compare them with the values given by the manufacturer. To take measurements, the parts must of course be clean, free of carbon deposits and oil residue. We refer to video 21 of this engine overhaul series for this. This table comes from the VW manual of our AB1300 engine. This book dates from 1970. In it you can see the most important values you will need to measure before assembling the cylinders and pistons of your VW engine. Due to the amount of measurements, we have divided this 20-second video into several parts. In part 1 of this video, we start with the piston ring gap, also known as piston ring end clearance, or end gap. Before we begin the measurements, we explain what ring gap is. The piston should have a smaller diameter than the cylinder because the piston will expand due to heat. We show here the clearance between the piston and the cylinder wall when the piston rings are not present. This drawing should clarify a few things. We replace the cylinder with this gray circle. We represent the piston in cold condition with this blue circle. Because of the difference in diameter between the piston and the inner wall of the cylinder, the loss of compression would be very high when the engine is cold. The piston rings serve to make the compression chamber of the cylinder airtight. A piston ring is shown with this black circle. You can see that the piston ring is open. The gap that remains after assembly in the cylinder is called ring gap. The piston, after starting the engine, will heat up fastest. So the piston rings must be able to move properly in the slots of the piston to allow the expansion of the piston. Here we show how the piston increases in diameter. The clearance between the piston and the cylinder gets smaller as the piston heats up. The heat from the piston will escape along the cylinder wall, heating up the cylinder. So the cylinder will also heat up and expand, but not to the same extent as the piston. The piston ring will follow the diameter of the cylinder to ensure the seal. Thus, the ring gap will increase as the cylinder expands. Now that we know what ring gap is, we will explain how to measure it. The ideal opening of the piston ring at room temperature is specified by the manufacturer as ring gap. Items 5 and 6 in the VW manual state the values for the piston gap of a standard Type 1 engine. These are between 0.25 and 0.45 millimeters for a new set of cylinders and pistons with new piston rings. When working on a used engine, it is better to consider the wear limit. The wear limit is the maximum value the ring gap can take if you want to still be able to use the parts. The maximum wear limit value for the ring gap is 0.95 millimeters. You notice that the values are different for the compression rings and for the oil ring. We'll come back to that in a moment. To determine the ring gap, you place the piston ring in the cylinder in a place where there should be no wear. That is, where the inside diameter of the cylinder is still practically the same as it was when it left the factory. That is where the piston rings do not reach, on the side of the engine crankcase. In this animation, you can see that the piston rings do not reach the side of the crankcase. So that part of the cylinder wall should still be the factory diameter. VW recommends positioning the piston ring 4 to 5 mm below the chamfered edge of the cylinder to measure the ring gap. The chamfer is not there by accident. It helps to slide the piston rings into the cylinder. This is a good time to check the inside of the cylinder. In video 24 of this series, we will explain how to prepare the inside of the cylinder with a honing brush. Before pushing the piston rings into the cylinder, check for any irregularities. We refer to video 25 of this series, in which we discuss how to machine the piston rings. Apply a little engine oil or assembly grease on the inside wall of the cylinder. Assembly grease is more convenient, it sticks to the wall better than engine oil. Push the first compression ring into the cylinder, use gloves, as piston rings can cut. The marking of the top of the piston ring plays no role for this measurement. To position the piston rings perfectly horizontally in the cylinder, we recommend using a caliper. You use the caliper as a depth gauge. You push, with the caliper locked at a value between 4 and 5 mm, the piston ring evenly into the cylinder. Take your time with this. The piston ring must be perfectly perpendicular to the cylinder wall, or the measurement will not be correct. Check that the piston ring is positioned at the same depth across the entire circumference. With the piston ring perfectly perpendicular to the cylinder wall, you are now ready to measure the ring gap. A new compression ring should have a ring gap between 0.30 and 0.45 mm. The wear limit is 0.90 mm. A 0.30 mm feeler gauge can be easily slid into the gap. A 0.40 mm feeler gauge can be slid in just barely. Be careful not to move the piston ring while measuring. It should always remain perpendicular to the cylinder wall to obtain a correct measurement. A feeler gauge of 0.45 mm doesn't fit. So the ring gap for this new compression ring is slightly larger than 0.40 mm. That is perfectly within the prescribed values, as stated in the VW workshop manual. That is well below the wear limit of 0.90 mm. Do the same for the second compression ring. If the ring gap turns out to be slightly too small, you can machine the piston ring. We explain how to do this in video 25 of this series. If the ring gap is much larger than the wear limit, then you need to look for other piston rings. Or, you mount a new cylinder piston set. When installing new piston rings, or a completely new set of cylinders and pistons, you need to follow the manufacturer's manual. Here we show the manual that comes with a new set of piston rings. No absolute values for the ring gap are given, you have to calculate the value yourself. The manufacturer says that the ring gap may be 3/1000ths of an inch, up to 4/1000ths of an inch, per inch of cylinder diameter. The inside diameter of the cylinder of our AB1300 engine is 77 mm. 77 mm is equal to 3.03 inches. So, the ring gap may be between 9/1000ths and 12/1000ths of an inch. Converted into millimeters, it is 0.23 and 0.31 millimeters. The ring gap of the oil rings of standard VW piston rings, you measure in the same way as the compression rings. The values for new oil scraper rings and the wear limit are listed in the table of the VW manual. It is different with these oil rings that come in most new piston ring kits. It consists of two thin rings and a thicker oil scraper ring. The two thin rings are mounted with their opening offset, as explained in video 21. With this type of setup, there is no ring gap to be measured, as with the original version. We explained how to measure the ring gap in this first part of video 22. That is one of the many measurements you will have to make on the cylinders and pistons. In part 2, we will discuss the side clearance of the piston rings. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon!